shots of green and white fluffy butterfly on yellow flowers throughout the video. Speaker is Outside Science Series host, Jessie Grace.
What happens to a rare butterfly when their favorite plants lose habitat? They move to a national park, of course. On this month's episode of Outside Science, we follow that butterfly to San Juan Island's National Historic Park. Check it out.
Speaker is Jenny Shroom from San Juan Island National Park. Jenny examining a butterfly in a clear container.
Like, they are so furry. Yeah, the first time, again, that I saw one close up, I was like, what's wrong with it? That can't be right. But that's how they all are.
So the species that we're working with in the rearing lab is the island marble butterfly. It was rediscovered on the island in 1998 after having been thought to have gone extinct for 90 years. You know, we've got about 20 years of research now devoted to the island marble butterfly, and we're starting to piece together, I think, the important components that the park needs to be doing in order to ensuring its survival.
Mist drilling in over water.
But other researchers started examining basically, so, you know, what are the plants that this species is using? And they come to find out it's using a non-native plant as its primary host plant. It's an unusual circumstance for the Park Service to be in that we have to foster a non-native plant in order to ensure the longevity of a very rare species.
Field of yellow flowers. Jenny showing flowers to a visitor.
So this is a non-native host plant that's found in the prairie.
The Island Marble Project has a bunch of collaborators, one of which is the Bureau for Land Management, BLM. BLM ended up getting funding to support a teacher in creating curriculum based on the Island Marble Butterfly. So Lori is a teacher at Lopez Middle School. She came over today and basically tagged along and learned everything that I could possibly dump on her about island marble butterflies. So we spent some time in the rearing lab and we did a release of some butterflies in the prairie.
Speaker is middle school teacher Lori Swanson. Butterfly being released onto a flower.
I'm looking forward to once a week I'll be coming here and helping them with the different stages of the larva and the butterfly and just see what I can do to support the science.
Pretending like I know what I'm doing.
And then slowly build curriculum to bring back into my classroom.
And then this one is tumble mustard, and this is actually the pretty much the stage that the female would be looking for. So even though you can see
Jenny showing Lori a green plant.
I really want the kids to feel empowered that what they think should happen, they can make happen.
Speaker is biological specialist Graham Krolbuck.
This is an exciting project because it's where I grew up. So I'm happy to be helping out and also to see it over a 5-year span, kind of see how it's changing and developing and how many more butterflies there are now than when I first started on it. So these are all new eggs that we're bringing in from the field that we thought were at risk out there. It's field work and you never know what's gonna happen next, so it keeps it fun.
Photos of green and yellow caterpillar.
So these are all caterpillars that were collected as eggs in the field recently.
Biological science technician Trent Lieber examining flowers growing in a lab.
It's actually really cool. I mean, this is probably my favorite conservation job I've done.
He flew off.
It's really nice to be involved with something that I help something stay alive and, you know, try to preserve the species.
Trent releasing a butterfly on a yellow flower.
I mean, this is satisfying to me because I love being outdoors and I love learning about my world, and I feel like the parks are a great place to do that.
Live butterflies in clear containers.
The science part of it is exciting because there is so much information still yet to be learned. So the releases, there's something about letting something go and just being like, be free. I mean, it's beautiful. And so that too, every time I do it, I get a little choked up.
Thanks for watching. Check back each month for another episode of Outside Science, Inside Parks.